What is going on, guys, and welcome back to JBLR Gaming. In today's episode, we are back on Euro Fishing. We're going for the Catfish Hunt Volume 2. I've checked out on the feed on the Xbox. They've actually released an update fixing the bugs, so hopefully now the game should work properly. I got my fingers crossed, hopefully it does. And we can land some catfish, because I've been looking forward to doing a Volume 2 on this video, because it's a good game, and let's hopefully get out there. We're at St. John's Lake again. The only thing different this time is I'm using different rods, that is it, but that is the only thing I'm using different. Same bait, same lake, so we're going to try and land some catfish. Right, so what I'm going to do is, let's go here. Alright, we're going to go on the little sand bit. Come on, right, here we go. Okay. Let's, I don't know, maybe I'm actually fishing. The difference is with these rods, guys, I'm fishing with Bait Shack 13 foot rods now. So last time I was fishing with 9 foot rods, so I've gone 3 foot in length bigger, so we got a bit more range. This bait looks alright here, doesn't it? Doesn't look too bad. Yeah, this will go here. Alright, so this is the peg we're choosing. Let's catch some catfish, hopefully. Hopefully that update has solved the problem, and we will catch some fish. Alright, so let's go on the blowback. Let's get the tiger nut out of there. Alright, hang on. Let me just make sure I can put my rod down, because I don't want to get a good cast, and then I can't lay the rod down. So, okay. I've only used these rods once since I've got them. I only got them yesterday, and I just went float, for fuck's sake. I've done a bit of float fishing with them just to get a feel for them, so I haven't actually done any catfishing yet. I'm actually doing it on this video, which is why I'm hoping the bug has fixed it and we will land some. Gravel, oh, don't do this, what's it doing? You know what, I think it's still buggy. See, like, it's just jumped from 40 yards to like 24. Let's just hope for the best now and see what happens. Okay, so rod 2, we're gonna go high vis pop up on a blowback again, but this time we're going straight out. What I'm gonna do is, if one, we'll just nail that. What we got, 38, looks it. Oh, no way. I wonder if it's just this lake. Because I was fishing in the observatory yesterday, and I wasn't having this problem when I was float fishing. But what I was saying is, guys, whichever bait picks up the fish, and maybe we'll switch all the baits over to the same then on each rod. Right, watch, we're at 45 yards. And it bounces back. Oh my god. I just realised it's on a float. What am I doing? Right, activate. That's what I wanted. These rods have got crazy range on them. Why has it put me back on the float? Because I changed the bait, didn't I? I never changed the fucking rig. Okay. But these rods have got crazy range, man. And just jump back here for, I don't know. Who knows, man? Okay, let's just hope for the best. Let's get the spot right out there. Try and get some bait on the thing, on the location. Okay, come on. Two, he's trying to land that number two. No. So the thing is, yesterday when I was on the observatory, I was catching fish. And now, because I'm filming it for you guys, I bet some distance, man. I bet it doesn't work out. So, boat number two's away. Game crashed a bit then, I don't know what happened there. That wasn't the video, that was the actual game. This is on the Hive's pop up, this one. Number two. He's putting up a fight, to be fair. This particular lake's number three is just gone as well. This particular lake is just over seven feet in this part here, and we're just a foot below the surface, so we're not too far down. Number three is just screamed off, so hopefully we don't lose that one. Have you noticed how they're disappearing below the surface, so, and you just can't see them? Normally the number three stays above and you can see where it is. Alright, let's see what we got. Oh, it's a nice fish, but it's not what we came for. Number three and number one are on the run. £27. It's not a bad fish, but you know, it's very welcome, but we're still here for the catfish. Let's go for number three. Hopefully we can land a catfish. That wasn't a bad fish though, £27. It's not exactly small, you know. Like I said, it's still very welcome as a species, you know, as a carp, but this particular session we are after catfish. Number one's just snapped off. There's some really big fish on this game now as well. On my feed on my Xbox, there was someone recently caught, I think it was £65. I can't remember, was it a carp or a catfish? I can't remember what it was, but it was huge. Definitely a good game though. Definitely recommend getting it if you haven't got it already. And if you have got it already, tell me what you guys think of it. Leave it in the comments below. Oh, it's another carp. Still a nice fish, but £19.5. But we're still here for the catfish. Alright, let's get number one. Number three back out. Number one. Game's glitchy for some reason. It keeps jumping. I don't know what's wrong with it. Maybe they didn't fix the bug, even though the feed did say that the new up. That's a wee bit. Even though the feed did say that it fixes its latest issues. I don't know what's going on. I wonder if it's just this lake. I'm not sure. Like I said, when I was float fishing yesterday over on the observatory, I wasn't having too much of a problem. I didn't film that session though, guys. That was just me getting a feel for my new rods. These are Bait Shack 13 feet rods. They are extreme range, so I can get them right out there really. So next thing on the list is some new reels. So there you go, look, 65 yards. That'd be a perfect like cast if it wasn't so glitchy. It's gonna bounce back now, so about 30, see. Yeah, the next thing is some new reels to go with the rods. I don't need to try and bait up a little bit more. What was that? What am I doing? I can truly say I've never done that when I've actually been fishing in real life. Oh, that. I've never done that. It's still working. Oh, did you guys see my mic cut off then? Sorry about that. I don't know what's going on. What's going on with this game? Did you see them disappear there? Alright, let's try again. Oh my god, what is going on? Back, whip it! There we go. How many of you guys actually use spuds in, if you are like real life fishermen, do you guys use spuds? Let me know in the comments below. And tell me what you use. What sort of bait do you stick in your spuds? I'm a spud user, not regularly, I use it sometimes. Not quite the big one, I've got the big one, like this yellow one. I've also got the mini red one. What rod's that? Number 3. Yeah, I don't use them regularly, like every session. It depends what I'm trying to get out there. Oh, that was a good bend, actually. And depends how far I'm fishing. If I'm doing a night session, then definitely I'm using the spud, you know, to bait up the area. So then once it gets dark, I don't have to touch it. But I'm not, like, about putting really, really excessive amounts of bait in. Like, I'll put so many spudfuls out just to see me through the night, you know. And the next morning I'll rebait up. I'm not about putting buckets and buckets out. Yeah, anyway guys, what are your spud mixes if you do use them in real life? Let me know in the comments below, man. And what's your target species? Like, are you a carp fisherman? Cat fisherman? Do you just go for any species? Are you happy as long as you're catching? I'm like that sometimes, you know, like, my main species is carp, but if the day's going slow, like, I will happily bring one of my rods in, you know, and just flip it over to a float and just fish, you know, a few yards out or something like that. Any species is welcome, you know, as long as I'm catching fish, I'm happy, I suppose, so. See, that fish is now ready to come out, just seen it turn blue, but it still stays for 30 yards. Oh, there it is. Have we got a cat? Hopefully, let's take a look. Damn! I mean, I'm not being ungrateful, man. It's a beautiful fish, but we're here for catfish, man. 28 pound 5 ounces. It's not a bad fish, but like I said, we're here for the cats. And now, if we was here for the carp, we wouldn't catch them. Let's see what number 1's got for us. We haven't brought number 1 in yet over fish on. And tiger nut normally is quite a good bait for catfish on this lake. I've fished it before. When I haven't been filming, just like freedom fishing, and I've caught cats on this. We're at a distance of 35 yards now, 36, 35. About 5 foot deep. These rods are super good though, they are doing work. I can't wait to get a new reel, so hopefully just make it a whole lot better. I am really enjoying this game though. Number 3 just ripped off by the sounds of it. Or was that number 2? I'm not quite sure. Which one did we just bring in? I've got to watch that bank there. There it is over there. Number 2, I'm sure it is. No, move away from the bank, come on. I'm pulling. There's nothing's happening. It don't feel small, I can barely move it. There we go, we're in. Okay, let's get them. Looks like another cop. Damn. Like I said, I'm not being ungrateful, but if we was targeting cop, like it's another cop, we wouldn't be able to catch him. It's a nice fish, man. That's a pale coloured fish. £21. I might have to title this video The Carp Hunt because it's not going well as a catfish hunt, really. Seems to be right over there by that bank, doesn't it? Hopefully it's not snagged up. Is it moving? Do you think they'd actually be, anyway guys, do you think that, this is what I was going to say, do you think there'll be any DLC for this game? Do you think they'll add more DLC? You know, as in like gear terms, like different brands, different baits and stuff like that. Hopefully they do, you know, because like I said, it's a really good game, especially if you're into fishing anyway, you know, it's a good game. But even if you're not, it's enjoyable for you. But as a fisherman, you know, for real, like in real life, I enjoy this game just as much. Obviously it's not like the real thing because you're not there, but it's as close as you can get in the winter months, you know, when it's super cold and you don't want to be out there. Right, it's time to come in. Let's see what it is. Another carp, do you think? What do you think? Here we go. Oh no, we got a cat. Finally. That's a big cat as well. What we got? 28 pounds, 10 ounces. That's a nice fish, man. Finally, we have a catfish. Beautiful colour as well. Okay, let's try and get another one. I told you the tiger nuts, especially for the... No, that wasn't even tiger nuts, what was it? Hive's pop-up. Oh, okay. Let's put this Hive's pop-up back out. If it gets us another one, then we'll switch the baits over to all Hive's and hopefully we'll get some more. Well, one. Oh, number two's off again. Here we go. Pull up, reel on the way down. Up, reel on the way down. What are we at? 31 yards. We're at a depth of just under 4 feet. Just under 2 feet now. Let's try and get it bringing back this way. I think the cool thing about this game, but I think it'd also be cool if it was in the game, is it doesn't snag your other line when it runs across it. I think they should have like an expert setting, like intermediate, like beginner, intermediate, you know, like a casual player, stuff like that, and then go expert where like it snags and stuff like that. And hopefully in a future DLC they could include some of that, or even where you get to tie your own rigs, you know, like if you press certain buttons to do the knots and stuff. I think that'd be dope, especially if it's an expert level. And also to be able to access like your bivy and your chair, you know, just like sit back and relax and just wait for the alarms and stuff. I think that'd be super dope. Add to the experience instead of standing there the whole time. That's a good bend, actually. That's got to be a good size fish. What we got now? Come on. Oh, it's another carp. Like I said, very welcome. But we are targeting catfish. It's a very pale coloured carp. £17, 13 ounces. Okay, let's get it back out. What are we at? 19 minutes. Okay, we've got about 10 minutes left. We're good. These rods have got extreme range. Look at that, 60 yards. This is a shame that it would, I can't leave it out there. As soon as I reel up to tighten up the line, it bounces straight back in. That's already out there, what am I doing? Number three. I'll tell you what guys, if we don't catch another catfish or one or two more catfish on this lake, we'll do another catfish hunt, but we'll head over to a different lake. We'll head over to the Spanish lake? Number one, is it number one or two, number one? Is it the Spanish lake? I think it is. We'll head over to there because that's got quite a few big cats. I've done one of the single player tournaments in there recently. About a week and a half ago. And I was holding that catfish on there. I actually come second in that tournament, which is pretty cool. Right, this is rod one. Let's see what we can get, man. Watch, we'll do a video soon. The carp hunt, and we'll all catch his catfish. I think it's pretty cool, you know, if they do decide to add new lakes as well, to have like predatory lakes where you can go like basically like a bit of winter fishing, you know, like pike fishing and stuff like that. I think that'd be pretty cool. Fishing for pike and bass and stuff like that. I think that'd be dope as well. Where you have to basically cast out using your lures and just basically slowly reeling to imitate the fish movement. I think that'd be dope. There's so much potential in this game, you know, that I can think of, and hopefully they fulfill that potential and they use, you know, the game to the maximum compatibility that you can, because there's so much they could put into it. And here we go. Number two just rolled off. Let's try and get this fish in as quick as we can. Oh my god. Come on, man. It's a nice fish, but again, we're after cats. 24, dead on 24. That's, it's a really nice fish, don't get me wrong. It's a big plate in mirror carp, but like I said, man, we nearly need these catfish. We really need them. Number two again. Here we go. Hive's pop up. I think the title of this video is going to be the kit. I've got some in the eye, that's why I'm not really. I think the title of this video will be The Catfish Hunt Volume 2 Gone Wrong Again. Such a dope game, though. Really such a dope game. I was like in two minds about buying it when it first came out, I'll be honest, you know. I was thinking, I don't know, because I've had fishing games before, like on the Xbox 360 and stuff like that, PlayStation 2 and stuff, and I was like, you know, they never really fulfill my pencil, because I've always liked fishing, you know. I've always been, whoa, that was a big boat. I was always into fishing, I've always liked fishing and enjoyed it as a, right, in real life, so it's another carp. And in the game, I wanted it to fulfill that sort of potential as well, like with that sort of fishing, you know, carp fishing, fish that I'm used to catching. Number three just ruled off, apparently. I think it's number three. Yeah, number three. No one ever done it until now, and this game, it does it, and it does it really, really well. You know, I'm so glad I paid for this game. I'm so glad I bought it, because it's super, you know, it's sick, man. I'm super glad it did. I was watching, like, before I bought it, for about a week, I was watching, like, Twitch live streams of people playing it. I was watching, like, the trailers. I was watching YouTube videos about it. I checked out the screenshots, everything, and then I committed to buy it, you know, because I was watching people on Twitch, and everyone was saying on Twitch, like, is it worth getting it, and everyone was, and, like, the Twitch players who were streaming, YouTubers, they were all saying it's definitely worth getting the game, you know. So, I committed to buy it, man. You know, it wasn't too much, it was only £14.99, £15, so. And for what it is, I think £15, you know, it's cheap, because the game is, you know, it's dope, and I think we got a great deal on the price of this game, to be honest with you. It really is a good game, and it's, like I said, it's got so much potential for future, like, DLC or add-ons and stuff like that, as long as they can sort the bugs out, which I'm sure they will, you know. But like I said, future DLC and add-ons is going to be epic. There's so much stuff they can do with this game. That's another car, that's another mirror. What do you reckon about it? Oh, it's going to come up £19.00. Dead on £19, not too bad. Like I said, this is more turning into a carp session. So next time we'll definitely go over to a different lake. What the fuck happened there? Alright, we're on 25 minutes. We have about 5 minutes left. I'm going to make about a 30 minute episode. I've done it again. We'll try and land one or two more, hopefully, in the next 5 minutes, if I can get the fucking rod back out. Come on. Oh my god, what are you doing, man? Back. And what? Oh my fuck. What is wrong with me? I cannot get a castaway. Like I said, I have never had that problem in real life. And I prefer to use turtle cast control in this game because it's a bit more realistic, you know. Oh my fucking god. You know what, I'm going to leave it there. Let's try a bit of margin catfishing. That's it. It's only 14 yards out. So, let's do this. We're going to get this out. Get number two out. Oh yeah, 35. I'm just going to jump back in a second. There we go. Okay, number one. I'm going to literally flip it over from a blowback to a waggler. Okay, and I'm going to drop it just in the middle of these two. So I can still just keep... Oh my god. I wanted a short cast. So I can keep my eye on them. But I can also try and pick a cat off in the margins. What happened there? Why is it doing that? It goes out and bounces straight back. Look, he's doing it again. What the fuck? We're going to have to long cast and roll back in. Oh my god, what is wrong with this game? I don't even think it's the game, to be honest. I think it's the lake that's bugging out. Obviously, the casting, that's my fault. But I mean, like, the way it was on the short cast bouncing straight back. Like, the long cast where it's going behind me. That, obviously, I'll take responsibility for that. That's just me being an idiot, but... Don't you wish you'd cast a flop that far? Because I fucking do. Let's bring it in. About 20 yards. About there. There we go. Just tighten the line up. Okay. Let's try and pick one off. Also, I think another cool feature of this would be, especially when you're waggler fishing, you know, to be able to trick a little bit of baiting. Little bits of baiting. My mic glitched out again then. That's why I repeated it. There's something seriously wrong with my fucking microphone. Yeah, I think it'd be pretty cool, so you could trick a few bits of baiting around the float. That'd be pretty dope as well. Like I said, the game's got so much potential. Minutes. We've got 2 minutes to catch a fish. Come on. Night fishing. I think that's probably the best time to tip off some cats, actually. We'll have to try that in the next cat session, because this one hasn't gone too well, so we will be doing another one. Maybe we'll head out at night. I'll tell you how we'll do it, guys. We'll go to a new lake in the daytime, see how it goes, and then we'll come back to this lake at night and see how it goes in. I don't think I'm going to be able to get one, really. Right, there we go. About 17 yards out. Should chair squeaky as hell, man. I really need to put some oil on this chair. I know you can hear it on the mic, innit? Oh, mate, sorry. I am sick. I don't know if you guys can notice through my voice. I've been sick for about 3 or 4 days now. You know what, remind me in the comments to put some oil in this chair before the next video. You know what, I think that's it guys, 31 minutes, we haven't pulled nothing, so I'm going to reel the rods in. Okay, that's it then. That was volume 2 of catfishing. Didn't go too well. We ended up pulling in more carp, so there will be another session. But for this one, it's over. We pulled in some nice fish, you know. Like I said, when it comes to the spot, leave it in the comments below. Let's see what you use and stuff like that. I'm interested to see what sort of bait you use in your spot. And your target species, what do you mainly fish for? So leave it in the comments as well. We will be back with another catfishing session on a new lake, and then I said we'll come back on this one in the dark, so we'll see how much better it is. But for now, that is it, guys. Hopefully you liked it. Don't forget to like anyway. Leave a like. What am I doing? Sorry. Don't forget to like and subscribe anyway, and we'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you all soon.